Hey everyone, hope you're doing well. This is Ujwal and in this tutorial we'll talk about polymorphism in Java. So if you're new here then please don't forget to subscribe. And now let's begin the video by just jumping at the agenda. So here we have the agenda for the video guys. First of all, we will see what is polymorphism. And after that, we'll see type of polymorphism. Following that, we'll see runtime polymorphism and we'll wrap up this video by discussing a programming example where we'll see that how we can achieve the runtime polymorphism. So what is polymorphism? So guys, a polymorphism is derived from two Greek words, the poly and morph, where the poly means many and morph means forms. So polymorphisms combined means many forms. In other words, we can say it is a concept where we can perform a single action in a different ways. Now let's talk about type of polymorphism guys. So polymorphism has two types, and the number one is compile time polymorphism, where the other is runtime polymorphism. And in this video we will talk about runtime polymorphism, not the compile time. But if you are wondering what is compile time, so just remember that overloading a static method, which we have already covered in Java, is an example of a compile time polymorphism. And let's go ahead and see that what is runtime polymorphism. Now let's talk about runtime polymorphism. So guys, in Java, runtime polymorphism is also known as dynamic method dispatch, and it is a process in which a call to an overwritten method is resolved at runtime rather than the compile time, which means which method to be performed is gonna decide at runtime rather than the compile time. We'll understand this runtime polymorphism in a much better way once we see the example. So let's quickly jump to that. So here we have the example of polymorphism guys, or the runtime polymorphism. In this I have made a class. The class name is vehicle, and this vehicle class has two methods. The first method's name is engine and the second method is brake. You can also see that it is the same example which we used when we covered the topic inheritance, just because this polymorphism is gonna use the concept of inheritance. And if you have not watched that video or you don't know about inheritance, I will definitely put the link in the I button here and the description. I would recommend to check that once. Now let's go further. And here we have this other class, the name is car, and it says the car extends vehicle, which means this car class is extending the properties of vehicle class, which means the vehicle class has these two methods, the engine and the brake method. But the moment the car says the car extends vehicle, now these both methods are available for the car class as well. At the same time, I'm making another method for the car class that is the same method, that is engine. So guys, you can also say that polymorphism is a concept where multiple methods can have a same name but different parameters, or the different message or different working. Okay, so here I have another class, that is a bike class. I'm saying the same thing, that bike extends the properties of vehicle class, which means now the bike class also have these two methods, the engine method and the brake method. Also, I'm creating another method for the bike, that is engine, which means the same method which I already have in vehicle class. And here, but the different parameters or the different messages. So now, where are we gonna use the runtime polymorphism? So guys, when we come to the main class, and you can see here that I've created the object of our particular classes. I've created the object of a vehicle class, object for the car class, and object for the bike class. And I believe you know how to create the objects. So after creating the objects, when you try to call the methods which we already created, like the engine method for both the classes with the name of their object and dot operator, let's run the program to see what the output we get. So guys, here we have the output for the program. You can see we have received engine for our first vehicle class engine method, new engine for our car class engine method, and new engine for our bike class engine method. So one thing you need to notice here, that once the car inherits the properties of vehicle class, which means this car has also these two objects, but when we are creating another object with the same name but different parameter, then at the runtime it gonna decide that which method it gonna run. It ran this method, it did not run this method. Although this car class was extending the properties of vehicle, but why it happened? Just because this engine method is exist within this particular car class, but this vehicle class method engine was the extended method, which means the car class was extending the engine method of vehicle class, but this car class already have an engine method. So this engine method got priority on the other engine method which belongs to the vehicle class. It happened same thing with the bike class when we receive the output as a new engine, because this bike class has its own engine method which exists within this particular bike class, and the other method that was the engine method that belongs to the vehicle class. I hope you understand the concept of polymorphism, guys. If you have any doubt, please comment below. I would love to answer those queries. That's all for this week, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you in the next one. Goodbye. Take care.